Today, I will present a case report about pneumonitis due to DLL full siphonage. It is a rare disease, so I hope after the presentations, I will give you some useful information about the disease. The petroleum DLL is a complex mixture of liquid hydrocarbons and mainly used as a fuel in transport vehicles. It can affect many organs through three ways: by ingestion, by skin contact, or by inhalation. Lung damage should be carefully considered because the hydrocarbon aspirations can cause death secondary to respiratory failure. The DLL can go into the lung by many ways, but there are some common situations of this disease. The first is when we siphon the fuel. Number two, when in the fire eater performance and maybe in choking in early. And today I will report a case due to when he siphoned the DLL. This is 30 years old man admitted to the hospital because of dyspnea and fever. This symptom appears 6 hours after he siphoned petroleum DLL by his mouth. On physical examination, the patient was conscious. The temperature was 39 Celsius, spine rate and blood pressure were normal. Oxygen saturation at room air is 95%. On auscultation, we found some crackles in both lungs and other systems were clinically normal. In the laboratory test, reason the white blood cell was 14, a CRP 9.9. And in chest CT, you can see some consolidation, and mostly in the right middle lobe. Based on this evidence, we diagnose patient with hydrocarbon pneumonitis following DLL siphonation. And you can see making a diagnosis is not a challenge, but the problem is how can we treat the patient? Because it is a rare disease, so until now we don't have a guideline for treatment. I review some literature and got some key points. The first is the supportive care, such as oxygen, the CPAP or intubations. It plays the most important role in the treatment strategies for hydrocarbon pneumonitis patients. And the second is corticosteroids. It remains controversial. Some study gave evidence that patients with hydrocarbon pneumonitis responded well to the steroid therapy. However, an animal study found no supporting evidence for their use. But when we use corticosteroids, the duration average is 3 to 5 days. The next is antibiotics. Most patients with hydrocarbon pneumonitis undergo treatment with antibiotics, and the indications for this are recurrence of fever, increasing infiltrates in chest radiograph, leukocytes or increased inflammatory markers such as CRP or procalcitonin. And the last is sputum or trachea or aspirate positive for the bacteria. And the last is when we do the bronchoscopy to do bronchoalveolar lavage. BAL is used not only to test sample, but also for treatment. And a few case reports have reported dramatic improvements after BAL in patients with hydrocarbon pneumonitis. And in this case, we treated the patient with broad spectrum antibiotics with methylprednisolone for 5 days. And we did bronchoscopy to do with BAL. The patient got better after 10 days and was discharged from hospital to continue taking oral antibiotic at home. But it was not the end. 10 days later, he coughed up about 5 to 10 milliliters blood and has to be hospitalized again with shortness of breath and high fever. The white blood cell is 13 and CRP is 12. And you can see in the CT scan, there are some localized lesions in the right middle lobe. So at this time, we treat diagnosed patient with lung abscess due to DSL-4. And he was treated with 3 times of antibiotics and recovered after 3 week treatment. And this is the chest X-ray before and after the treatment. Now you can see the cause of this disease is so complicated. And the question for us is how can we prognosticate for the patient? The bronchus is affected by the first volume of aspiration. The more volume you breathe in, and the more dangerous you got. And number 2 is characteristic of the DSL. The materials with low viscosity, low surface tension, and high volatility are far more toxic than others. And number 3 is severity of the patient and the adequacy of medical care. The typical clinical course average is 5 to 10 days. The complication and mortality rates are 7.5% and 2.5% respectively. And finally, I got some main ideas for you. The first is pneumonitis due to DSL is a rare disease. Making a diagnosis is often not a challenge. We base on history, based on symptoms, and chest X-ray and inflammatory markers. The therapeutic strategies include supportive care, with antibiotics, with corticosteroid, and we do bronchoscopy to do BAL. And the last is hydrocarbon pneumonitis, rarely cause severe mobility or motility in patients if we diagnose and treat promptly. Thank you for your attention.